On April 7, 1964, IBM announced the System 360, which many regard as the first modern mainframe. 50 years later, IBM still develops and builds the mainframe at its Poughkeepsie campus in upstate New York on the banks of the Hudson River. Despite repeated predictions of their demise, mainframes still power much of today's critical infrastructure, including banks and airline reservation systems, and the Poughkeepsie campus turns out about 300 mainframes every year.
So if you look across an industry snapshot, about 92% of the top 100 banks use a mainframe. Just about every credit card transaction goes through a mainframe. It's very relevant in insurance, healthcare, and the customers like the mainframe because, first of all, one of the key things is it's one of the unique platforms where they get to help design the platform, right? We take input from our customers and utilize that to develop the future generations. The resiliency, scale, performance is unparalleled, and it's really a cutting-edge platform from a business resiliency and cloud perspective.
IBM likes to say the mainframe has kept changing over the years to stay relevant, but the way it talks about the system has stayed remarkably constant.
One computer family for commercial, scientific, and communications applications. A modular design that would enable the customer to have a system with the speed, storage capacity, and input-output units custom suited to his precise needs. The flexibility of being able to add on or remove peripheral units readily as his needs change. Compatibility between second-generation programs and third-generation technology.
Each mainframe that IBM designs is custom-built for businesses, and the systems can easily top $1 million each. This one here is being tested before being sent to a major airline to run their reservations and flight systems. At the facility in Poughkeepsie, IBM has a 67,000-square-foot test floor with 184 mainframe test systems. They undergo load and stress tests to make sure they'll be able to handle the computational tasks required by the enterprises using them. One section of the test center simulates a range of temperatures from 10 to 32 degrees Celsius. The upper range could simulate a broken air conditioner or a warmer climate. IBM's Poughkeepsie facility has changed over the years. The campus today holds empty buildings, which once housed some of the 12,000 employees in the company's heyday. That number now cut in half. All the while, though, the mainframe's characteristics and purpose have stayed surprisingly consistent.
And it's not something you may see when you're out there. You don't see a physical mainframe, but most things you touch during the day are attached to the mainframe. Every time you go to the ATM, you use your credit card, right? There's a saying we use of, can you go 5 minutes without using the mainframe? And if you really think about how pervasive the mainframe is, it's hard to go 5 minutes without using it. So.
In Poughkeepsie, New York, Nick Barber, IDG News Service.